the operator of Okada Manila files charges against the camp of Japanese tycoon Kazuo Okada following the group's supposedly violent takeover of the casino hotel last week. Let's get more details from our correspondent, Jackie Pascual. Go ahead, Jackie.
Good afternoon, Rain. Tiger Resort Leisure and Entertainment Inc., or TRLEI, has filed kidnapping and serious illegal detention, grave coercion, and unjust vexation against Japanese tycoon Kazuo Okada's group over last week's takeover of Okada Manila Hotel and Casino in Parañaque. TRLEI filed the cases at the Department of Justice. TRLEI alleges that on May 31, Okada, represented by former directors Tony Boy Cuanco and Bindo Espeleta, accompanied 50 private guards and police, barged into Okada Manila to take over the premises. TRLEI directors Michaki Satate and James Lorenzana said they were dragged outside the ballroom while Japanese Hajime Tokuda was allegedly kidnapped, brought to an unknown car by private guards before he was taken home. The case stems from what TRLEI calls a violent takeover of Kazuo Okada's camp, led by Cuanco and Espeleta last May 31. The incident stems from a Supreme Court ruling issuing a status quo ante order in April this year. The SQAO orders the parties to maintain the status quo prevailing prior to Kazuo Okada's removal as stockholder, director, chairman, and CEO of TRLEI in 2017. In 2017, Okada was removed from his post due to allegations of mismanagement and corruption. TRLEI counsel Estrella El Amparo asserts Okada only had one share prior his removal as stockholder and he cannot resume his position as chairman and CEO because only Tiger Resort Asia can nominate the said position. El Amparo added that Tiger Resort Asia, which owns over 99% of TRLEI, is not recognizing Kazuo Okada's camp and even calling it a fake or sham management. They will now, or TRLEI will now, issue a manifestation with the Supreme Court to clarify its status quo ante order. And she hopes that SC will be made to clarify to the public that it was never the intention of the SQAO to take over in such a forcible takeover. That's the statement of El Amparo. She also questions why Kazuo Okada's camp has appointed a new board of directors, even if the SC ruling was to maintain a status quo in 2017. Rain, we ABS-CBN tried to seek an interview or a statement from the camp of Kazuo Okada, and their staff or their PR say that they cannot accommodate our request for now. And that's the latest. Rain, back to you.
Thank you so much for that report, Jackie Pascual.